Now we'll calculate the cylinder's kinetic energy as it rolls. Right, as it goes along, clearly it's in motion, it has some kinetic energy. We're going to calculate it strictly for the rotation and see where that takes us. So recall that we have a cylinder. It's rotating about this point where it's in contact. So I'll put an X there. That's the rotation axis. At any moment, whatever's there, that's the rotation axis. As it moves in time, that's always the rotation axis, but different parts of the cylinder are there, and it's in a different place. But in a snapshot, we can say it's rotating around that point. All right, so we look at it and we say, well, if it's pure rotation, we're just going to think about the rotation, then the kinetic energy is 1/2 pi omega squared, right? All right, so let's now think about what is the moment of inertia around that point. And this is where we need the parallel axis theorem. Right, we're very good at the moment of inertia of a cylinder around its center. 1/2 mr squared, so this thing has radius r, mass m. For parallel axis, we move over, in this case, a distance r, and add an mr squared. So I'm going to say I, and I'll put an x, meaning there, is equal to the moment around the center of mass. That would be 1/2 mr squared for a cylinder, plus m. And then it's the separation between the center of the mass and the rotation axis, which in this case happens to be the radius again, because that's how we roll. All right, so let's keep calculating here and say then the kinetic energy equals 1/2. What we're going to do is say that times omega squared, right? 1/2 ICM plus MR squared times the angular velocity as it rolls along. All right. So what we would then say is this is 1/2 ICM omega squared plus, and then for this term, we'll say 1/2 MR squared. But for this term, let's replace omega with the value related to the velocity of the center mass. Right, omega is velocity of the center mass over r squared. Okay, so let's see, what have we done? We said it's 1/2 I omega squared, there's I, we plugged it in, and now we're going to do something with these two terms. So this looks like rotational kinetic energy about the center of mass. So if we thought of this rotation in part as pure rotation about the center of mass, then this is the Ke rotational. What about this part? Plus r squared, 1/2 mv squared. Well, that's the translational kinetic energy. So the total energy actually kind of naturally breaks up nicely into a rotational part plus the translational part, based on the fact that it's rotating at omega and it's translating at the velocity of the center of mass. So that's nice to see. The energy says you can kind of think of this as both of those happening at once, and you can solve problems that way. Another way you can look at it as both of those happening at once is like this. Let's look at the actual velocity vectors for different parts of this object. So let's think of this as pure rotation. Just like for energy, we had the result that you could treat it in pure rotation. And in pure rotation, let's look at three points: the top, the bottom, and the middle. If this thing's spinning, moving forward, then this must be going forward, and this must be going backwards, and the middle isn't moving at all. Right? This down here must be going at VCM, that point, because it's translating, the whole thing's translating at VCM. We thought about that earlier. This is the same, I'll make it look the same, must be going forward at VCM. Now we say we can think of this as pure rotation plus pure translation. All right, if it's translating, not even rotating, what's the velocity of those three points? Well, they're all just moving at VCM, the velocity of the center of mass. All right, so now we can just vector sum these. We can say, well, how is it really moving then? If we can think of it as the sum of those two, the top is moving at 2 VCM. The middle is moving at VCM. Velocity of the center of mass. And what do you get when you add those? Nothing. Not moving at all. And it turns out, of course, that is what's really happening. As the thing rotates over this point doesn't move, this is at center mass velocity, and this is going twice as fast because it's twice as far away. So there, in terms of energy and in terms of thinking of the velocities, we can treat rolling as the combination of pure rotation and pure translation.